It is now time to meet the starting field for the 2011 CRA Super Series Seal Wrap Repair Tape Redbud 300. Starting on the pole, he's already got two victories this year at the Bearfield Speedway and at Lucas Oil Raceway in Indianapolis. Brian Campbell out of Wyoming, Michigan, and alongside him, paying homage to fallen racer William Mefford, Jeff Lane driving car number 46. Row number two sees Noblesville, Indiana driver Joe Beaver, a longtime street stock competitor here at the Anderson Speedway, and Chase Elliott, son of longtime NASCAR star Bill Elliott. Row three, welcome back Johnny Van Dorn out of Coopersville, Michigan, and Scott Hance will go alongside him. Row number four, Derek Griffin out of South Bend, Indiana, driving the Seal Wrap Repair Tape entry for Welsh & Wilson Motorsports, and Mason Mingus out of Brentwood, Tennessee. Andy Ponstein makes a rare start in the series. He'll go from the inside of row number five. Alongside him, longtime ASA veteran Peter Cozzolino. Row six, CJ Lurie will go in the other Seal Wrap Repair Tape entry for Welsh & Wilson Motorsports, and Jason Deitch out of Edgerton, Ohio. Robert Maynor will go from the inside of row number seven. He's from Heartland, Wisconsin. And alongside him, Spring Valley, Illinois driver Ross Kenseth. He's got two wins this year at Columbus and at Plymouth the last time out. The inside of row number eight sees Fenton, Missouri's Ken Schrader, a longtime short track competitor, and Aaron Pierce from nearby Daleville, Indiana. Row number nine, Steve Doerr. He picked up his first career CRA Super Series win up at M40 a couple weeks ago. And High Point, North Carolina's Ryan Blaney goes from the outside. Row 10 sees Greenfield, Indiana driver Kenny Tweedy, and alongside him, Damon Eckhoff, who got his first career sportsman win at IRP last month. Landon Kling, driving the Brad Keselowski developmental effort, will go from the inside of row number 11, and Rick Turner, driving the Great Deal Savings Magazine entry, will go from alongside. Row 12, Jim Crabtree Jr. from Muncie, Indiana, and Colin Nicolai from Piqua, Ohio. Row number 13, Terry Fisher Jr. from Ossian, Indiana. He won up at Angola back on July 4th, and Jay Newick will go from the outside. Row 14, sportsman competitor Mark Lambert makes his first career Super Series start today, and alongside him, Jack Smith, a regular over on the Jags All-Star Tour. Row number 15, Jason Atkinson, another sportsman competitor, and alongside him, Fred Hopkins, a frequent competitor down at the Mount Lawn Speedway. That is the 30 cars and drivers that make up the starting field for the 2011 Seal Wrap Repair Tape Redbud 300.
Everybody stand up, wave something while you're bright, and send them off on tonight's Seal Wrap Redbud 300 as they get ready to go racing on tonight's great race heading your way. We get the two-lap signal from starter Brian Duggan. Two more laps before we come racing. The Champion Racing Association Super Series late models with their big one of the year here at Anderson Speedway as we come to the one lap signal this time down. And now, ladies and gentlemen, Ed Martin Toyota, Hoosier Park Racing and Casino, Great Deals Savings Magazine, Welsh & Wilson Motorsports, Seal Wrap Repair Tape, and Action Entertainment and the Champion Racing Association presents the Redbud 300 as we come out of turn four to the green flag. And we are underway. Down the back straightaway we go racing. Jeff Lane jumps to the early lead in car number 46. Brian Campbell ready in second place, followed by Joe Beaver in third. Chase Elliott in fourth. And a battle between Johnny Van Dorn and Scott Hance for fifth place. And Johnny Van Dorn will win that battle. So Hance into sixth, followed by Mason Mingus in seventh. Derek Griffin in eighth. Andy Ponstein in ninth. And Ross Kenseth rounds out the top 10 here in the early going. Lane with about a length lead as we head down around turn number four. Five laps quickly recorded. Everybody seemingly off to a pretty good start here in the Redbud 300. Brian Campbell holds on in second place. Joe Beaver in third. Chase Elliott in fourth. Johnny Van Dorn about two or three lengths back in fifth. Then Scott Hance in sixth. Mason Mingus in seventh. Derek Griffin in eighth. Ross Kenseth in ninth. And Peter Cozzolino now moves into the top 10. Jeff Lane continuing to pace it. As he leads the first 10 laps of the Redbud 300. Brake checking going on down the back straightaway with the 29 car of Landon Kling. Jeff Wayne now coming in on the back of the field now. So it looks like Freddie Hopkins going to become a lap car soon as Jeff Lane now is bringing the field to the back of the field. Here on lap 15, Lane now begins to catch the field and Freddie Hopkins becomes the first lap car of the event. Jason Atkinson also going a lap down in the 71 car. As Lane continues to lead him down the main straightaway, here's 17 laps deep into the event. Coming up on the 49 car, Colin Nicolai. Colin Nicolai now going a lap down in car number 49. Three laps now recorded. Freddie Hopkins now beginning to smoke a little bit in the 99 car. Lap 25, Jeff Lane the leader, Brian Campbell running second, Joe Beaver third, Chase Elliott fourth, Johnny Van Dorn fifth, Scott Hance is sixth, Mason Mingus is seventh, Derek Griffin eighth, Ross Kenseth ninth, Peter Cozzolino tenth, Ryan Blaney running 11th, Damon Eckhoff 12th, Aaron Pierce is 13th, Jason Beach 14th. Andy Ponstein, 15th. Kenny Schrader is 16th. Kenny Tweedy, 17th. Steve Doerr is 18th. C.J. Leary, 19th. Rick Turner, 20th. Jim Crabtree, Jr., 21st. Robert Maynard, 22nd. Terry Fisher, Jr., 23rd. Jay Newick, 24th, and we got problems in turn two. So Jim Crabtree, Jr., and the 26 of Rick Turner, Lockie Horns, over in turn number two. Jeff Lane, your leader, in car number 46. As we get ready to come back, Green Flag Racing in the Seal Wrap Red Bud 300. Jeff Lane, your leader. Joe Beaver able to pick up some positions. Chase Elliott running third in car number nine. The 61 of Johnny Van Dorn running in fourth place, followed by the 20 car of Brian Campbell in fifth. Campbell falling from second to fifth after that restart. Kenny Schrader now off the pace in the 52 car as he is slowing down. So Ken Schrader now off the pace in the 52 car. Maybe something going awry in his car as he's falling all the way to the back of the field and now on the bottom of the racetrack. So Schrader with a problem in the 52 car as he heads into the pit and not knowing what's going on with his car. And the yellow flag out once again. Jay Neweek in the 84 car. A little shuffling right there in the middle of the pack around the 11 of Consolino. A little brake checking going on, but everybody seems to be straight and all right now. And problems in the corner now. Scott Hintz way down on the bottom of the racetrack, like something broke, almost ran over Joe Beaver, and then straight back up the track. And certainly no place for Ross Kenseth to go except into Scott Hintz and into the wall. Back to the green flag in the Seal Wrap Red Bud 300. And Chase Elliott giving Jeff Lane all he wants here on the restart. Lane and Elliott raising that lead. Elliott actually waiting across the line as they came across. So Jeff Lane not giving up easy, and Lane will lead him across on this one. So Elliott falls in behind Lane as they go racing around three and four. It's Jeff Lane and Chase Elliott with Chase in the chase mode. as they head down the back straightaway around three and four they come. Johnny Van Dorn running in third, Joe Beaver in fourth. Brian Campbell in fifth, Peter Cosolino sixth, Mason Mingus in seventh, Derek Griffin in eighth, Aaron Pierce in ninth, Damon Eckhoff in tenth. Eighteen of Robert Maynor now being pushed to the grass out of it. Two laps now recorded here in the CRAP Red Bud 300. Chase Elliott running in second, Johnny Van Dorn in third, Joe Beaver fourth, Brian Campbell in fifth, Peter Cosolino sixth, Mason Mingus in seventh, Derek Griffin in eighth, Aaron Pierce ninth, Damon Eckhoff in tenth, Kenny Tweedy in 11th, Jason Deach in 12th, C.J. Leary in 13th, Jack Smith in 14th, Steve Dorr in 15th. Now problems down the back straightaway. Well, the 28 of Jack Smith getting loose down the back straightaway, and Terry Fisher Jr. Jeff Lane trying to hold off the hard charge of Chase Elliott as we come back green. Lane getting a much better run on Chase Elliott that time, and not having any problem at all handling Elliott on the restart. Cars, pieces flying every place down the back straightaway. And the 10 of Ryan Blaney involved, as you can see him come to a halt here on pit road. So we should come back to green flag racing this time down in the Seal Wrap Red Bud 300. Jeff Wayne brings him to green. Peter Cosolino having problems over in turn number two and the yellow flag out. Jeff Lane. We'll lead him across one more time. Chase Elliott running second, Johnny Van Dorn third. Joe Beaver running fourth and 31. Aaron Pierce running in fifth place. Terry Griffin running in sixth, Brian Campbell seventh, Mason Mingus in eighth, Kenny Tweedy ninth, and CJ Larry running in 10th place. Jeff Lane, less than a length lead on Chase Elliott. Down the back straightaway, around three and four they come. Jeff Lane, Chase Elliott, Johnny Van Dorn, and Joe Beaver. Now putting a little bit of distance on the rest as they head down the back straightaway. Chase Elliott never leaving. Jeff Lane as they run hard, 12.813 for Jeff Lane on that lap. A pretty blistering pace going on right now. And this time down, it'll be 100 laps. The race one-third over, 100 laps in of the Seal Wrap Redbud 300. Jeff Lane leads it in car number 46, 9, Chase Elliott runs second. 61, Johnny Van Dorn is third, 0, Joe Beaver is fourth. 31, Aaron Pierce is fifth. 4, Derek Griffin runs sixth. 20, Brian Campbell seventh. 8-11, Mason Mingus is 8th, 2, Kenny 29th. 14, C.J. Larry is 10th. 00, Andy Ponstein runs 11th. 63, Jim Crabtree Jr. is 12th. 26, Rick Turner is 13th. 7, Jason Dish 14th. 21, Mark Lambert is 15th. 81, P.J. Fisher is 16th. 71, Jason Atkinson 17th. That's the end of the lead lap cars. Dennis, Steve Dorr, one lap down in 18th. Jay Newick in 84 is two laps down in 19th. 49, Colin Nicolai is 20th. Peter Cosolino, 21st in car number 11. And 29, Landon Kling, 22nd. Jeff Lane continuing to lead him down the back straightaway with Chase Elliott glued to his donkey. Johnny Van Dorn right there in third and Joe Beaver in fourth And from there, it's see ya. Aaron Pierce almost a full straightaway back in fifth place. Derek Griffin in sixth in the four car, followed by the 20 of Brian Campbell in seventh and Mason Mingus in eighth. So another four car grouping racing nose to tail for position. Now we see the double zero of Andy Ponstein into the pit. Andy Ponstein, who was running 11th in the race, now heads into the pit. And Jason Atkinson pulling out of it in the 71 car by the time Rick Turner loops it coming out of turn number four. Back to green flag racing here at lap 123. Terry Fisher Jr. and the 49, Colin Nicolai, lock horns in turn three. To the green flag we go racing. And Joe Beaver and the four car of Derek Griffin getting a hook down in the corner. Thought we saw Joe Beaver trying to give Aaron Pierce a little bit of bumper on the restart. Jeff Lane with 136 laps complete here in the first 150 of the Seal Wrap Redbud 300. Jeff Lane continuing to pace it with Chase Elliott running in second round the tail of Jeff Lane. 141 laps complete. Johnny Van Dorn in third, Aaron Pierce running in fourth, and Mason Mingus in fifth, Kenny Twitty sixth, and Brian Campbell in seventh place. Campbell now trying to move on Tweedy for sixth place as they come around the corner. Ryan Campbell trying to get back up to sixth and gets the job done. Campbell now back up to sixth place in the 20 car. Peter Cozzolino and C.J. Leary. Getting together down in the corner. Dub break for C.J. Leary as he was running on the lead lap cars. Peter Cozzolino about four laps down. The white flag out lap 149, so we will not go back to green as the crews will begin their 15-minute break. And you'll get your 15-minute break here in one lap. So the halfway point now for the Sealwrap Redbud 300. As the cars head to the zoo for feeding time. So it's Aaron Pierce ready to bring him back to green flag action in the second half of the Sealwrap Repair Tape Redbud 300 as we're off and away once again. Hey everybody, fresh and ready to go racing for another 150 laps off the world's fastest quarter mile. Pierce looking stronger than he did in the first half as he leads them here at the start, but gets a wiggle from his competition. As now we see the nine of Chase Elliott wanting a part of the action as he and Pierce exchange a little paint and Elliott goes into the lead. So Chase Elliott, who has been in the chase mode the entire race, now takes over the lead of the Redbud 300. Chase Elliott cranking on some pretty impressive laps here once he gets out into some clean racetrack. Down into the 12-6 bracket. Nobody else running close to that. 12-8s is as close as anybody else is running to that. Aaron Pierce in second with the 20th. Brian Campbell in third now. Johnny Van Dorn in fourth, followed by the 8-11 of Mason Mingus in fifth. Kenny Twitty sixth. Steve Doerr running in seventh. Rick Turner in eighth place. Jeff Lane in ninth. Jim Crabtree Jr. rounding out the top 10. Jason Deitch in 11th. Brett Miles Jr. running in 12th place. Mark Lambert, 13th into 181. Carr, the last car on the lead lap. Brian Campbell just putting that nose right underneath the back end of Aaron Pierce. Tony Van Dorn watching from fourth place as Campbell really burying that nose underneath the back bumper of Pierce. Once again, Campbell trying to find some racing room on Aaron Pierce, but Pierce able to slam the door and pedal away on Campbell as they came off the corner that time. Campbell seemingly having a little faster car than Pierce, but so far Pierce has been able to dominate. Five cars really racing hard for second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. That is the kid from Dawsonville right now, Chase Elliott. No longer in chase mode, but in leader mode. As he leads them down the main straightaway, 172 laps deep into this one. The 84 car now beginning to smoke a little bit. Jay Neewick as he heads into the pit area. Neewick showing problems in the 84 car. Good Chase Elliott. Building up almost a two-turn lead, not quite, but almost, as they head down the back straightaway around three and four. 178 laps now complete here in the Seal Wrap Red Bud 300. Once again, the 20 car, Brian Campbell, trying to find some racing room on the inside of Aaron Pierce, but no place to go. And also Johnny Van Dorn trying to race on Campbell. But Campbell able to slam the door that time on Van Dorn. So Van Dorn having to back out into fourth place and holding Van Dorn at bay. Campbell still setting his sights on the 31 of Aaron Pierce. And while that battle continues, Chase Elliott continues to stretches lead a little bit here at lap 182. Campbell comes up within about 6 feet of Aaron Pierce as they race around three and four. No place really to move on Pierce as Pierce a master at using the groove here at Anderson Speedway, as he does so well in the little 500. Campbell looking that low groove in especially in turns one and two on Pierce, but Pierce right in that main groove around one and two that he uses so well. So Campbell will have to figure out something else on Aaron Pierce, because I don't really think that will ever work on him. Now, as Pierce slows down a little bit, but Pierce right now running at the 12.9 mark, and that's just about where Campbell's running. Chase Elliott seems to have slowed it down just a little bit to what he was running, now right at about 13 flat, but that's about what everybody else is doing. They've all slowed down into about 13 flat or a little bit over, as the track probably greases up a little bit, gets a little bit slicker as the race progresses now to lap 190, as this half is progressing nicely. Elliott working on some slower cars down the main straightaway. Kenny Tweedy now joining that second, third, fourth, and fifth group, as Tweedy has been able to run them down now. So Tweedy will make that a group of five now that is in chase mode of Chase. And Elliott's lead just not quite as big as it was for a while. And it seems as though that he just not quite as blistering a pace as it was in the early going here in the second half. Brian Campbell in the 20 car, less than a link behind the 31 of Aaron Pierce as they head around one and two. Now putting a little bit of distance on the 61 of Johnny Van Dorn. So Van Dorn kind of dropping back away from that chase mode of second and third place, watching them do their thing, but Campbell certainly not falling back from the 61 car, or the 31 car of Aaron Pierce any at all, as Campbell staying right with him and is right on his donkey here on the main straightaway. So 200 laps now recorded in the Seal Wrap Redbud 300. And Chase Elliott the leader, as we run it down here for you. Chase Elliott the leader, 31. Aaron Pierce is second, followed by the 20 of Brian Campbell. 61, Johnny Van Dorn is fourth. 8-11, Mason Mingus is fifth. 2, Kenny Tweedy is sixth. 46, Jeff Wayne is seventh. 10S, Steve Doerr is eighth. 26, Rick Turner, ninth. And 7, Jason Beach, 10th. 0, Brett Miles Jr. runs in 11th place. 63, Jim Crabtree Jr. is 12th. Those are your lead lap cars. Then now we have a yellow. So the first yellow of the second half now in existence here at lap 204. Jim Crabtree Jr. in car number 63, looping it down in the corner.
Four
by Green Flag Racing. Elliott had that big lead. Now it is gone. Johnny Van Dorn rides in third with Aaron Pierce. Once again, and about three or four lengths back in fourth place. Mason Mingus in fifth, Kenny Tweedy in sixth. Trying to get a little bit racy with Brian Campbell on that lap. Chase Elliott. Yeah, car number nine leading it here at 222. Stretching his lead ever so slightly on Brian Campbell. Johnny Van Dorn now backing away from Campbell a little bit, and Aaron Pierce continuing to drop back a little bit into 31 in fourth place. Quite a good dogfight for fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, and ninth between the 8-11 of Mason Mingus, the 2 of Kenny Tweedy, the 46 of Jeff Lane, the 10 of Steve Dorr, and the 7 of Jason Deitch. Now Brett Miles Jr. enters that group and makes it a six-pack. Turner now showing signs of smoke on his car. So Turner showing signs of something going awry and now whoops it in the corner. So Rick Turner will once again bring the yellow flag here in the Seal Wrap Red Bud 300. With a loop in the corner. 234 laps complete in the Red Bud 300. Johnny Van Dorn giving Brian Campbell a little bit of bumper that time on the restart. Chase Elliott once again beginning to open it just a little bit. Van Dorn in chase mode on Brian Campbell as they come around three and four. Aaron Pierce by himself in fourth place. Mason Mingus in fifth. Jeff Lane sixth. Lane trying to move on Mingus now. And Lane in trouble with Mingus as they come down the main straightaway. Well, you can see that one developing. Lane got underneath of Mingus around turns four. As we get ready to come back, green flag racing here at lap 245 of the Seal Wrap Redbud 300. And Brian Campbell losing second place to Johnny Van Dorn. Well, Van Dorn able to take over second place on the restart. Brian Campbell now in third, Aaron Pierce in fourth place. Kenny Tweedy in fifth. Brett Miles Jr. running in sixth place. Steve Doerr in seventh. Jason Deach in eighth. Jim Crabtree Jr. in ninth. Derek Griffin in 10th place. Laps to go here in the Seal Wrap Redbud 300 as the all flag comes out once again. Back to green flag racing. And Brett Miles Jr. off the pace in car zero. Elliott continuing to lead it. And the four car of Derek Griffin coming to a stop in turn number four, and he got it fired again. Brian Campbell, Kenny Tweedy running 3-4 as we get ready to come back to the green flag. Chase Elliott and Johnny Van Dorn exchanging a little paint on the restart. Some more paint being exchanged back in the field. Like I said many times, you come out of this one unscathed. You've had a great night. If you come out with your car in one piece. 269 laps now recorded. Chase Elliott, Johnny Van Dorn running second. Brian Campbell in third. Steve Doerr in fourth. Jim Crabtree Jr. in fifth. Kenny Tweedy sixth. Aaron Pierce seventh. Jason Deach in eighth. And Mark Lambert in ninth. Jeff Lane rounds out the top 10. Eight cars on the lead lap. Van Dorn trying to chase down Chase as they go racing. And now Van Dorn all of a sudden just kind of backs away. So Van Dorn now with problems. Johnny Van Dorn with problems as he's got the arm out. And apparently Van Dorn maybe with a tire or something going down on his car. So a tough break for Johnny Van Dorn. But that's been kind of Johnny Van Dorn's season this year, as things have just not worked out for the defending series champion. So Chase Elliott with nobody in chase mode behind him now. Brian Campbell in second. Steve Dorr now works his way all the way up to third. So Steve Dorr just hanging in there after starting in 17th position and now is in the hunt for this one. Kenny Tweedy starting 19th position and in fourth place. So a lot. And Jim Crabtree Jr., if he ends up there, started 23rd and will end up fifth. So 288 laps now recorded. And this time down 10 laps to go for Chase Elliott. So Chase Elliott now 10 laps away from victory. Jim Crabtree Jr. letting go now. Jim Crabtree Jr. letting go. You could feel the vibration here in the tower the last couple laps. And was afraid that was going to happen. And Jim Crabtree Jr. letting go in car number 63. Chase Elliott looking good in the driver's seat. From the place he wants to be with five laps to go. One more time to defend the double up restart. To the green flag we come, and we're off and away. And Steve Dorr moves into second place in car number 10. Kenny Tweedy kind of gets tweaked back into sixth position. Now there's 297 laps complete and 3 laps remaining. Chase Elliott, 2 lap, 298 in the white flag coming up. The white banner will be coming up this time down as Steve Dorr on the back bumper of Chase Elliott as we come for the white flag. Steve Dorr is now or never. Dorr trying to go on the outside of Chase Elliott, and here we come for the money. It's down to the checkered flag, and Steve Dorr will win it. Steve Dorr pulls it off here at the start finish line. Wow! Steve Dorr pulling off an absolute dynamite finish here in the Seal Wrap Red Bud 300 to win this great race here this evening. What an awesome drive by Steve Dorr here on the last lap. Wow. Steve Dorr, who started 17th in the Race Car Engineering FLF Race Cars All-Star Performance Chevrolet from Lakeland, Florida, doing the lap of his life here on the last lap of the Seal Wrap Red Bud 300. What a move here on the main straightaway. Steve Dorr, give it up for him. Steve Dorr. Wow. What an awesome performance by Steve Dorr. He's catching his breath down in the infield right now, getting some hydration going, as I'm sure all the drivers need down here in the infield. What an awesome finish here in the Red Bud 300. Chase Elliott doing an absolute awesome job of leading this event the second half, except for when it counted. There's Chase Elliott doing a great job here in the 9 car. Man, what a finish here to the Seal Wrap Red Bud 300. That was awesome. Steve Dorr in a never say die situation and pulling alongside of Chase Elliott. And bringing it home down the main straightaway. Wow. Can't hardly wait for the winning interview when we go down trackside for that one.
Go ahead.
Can I let Arm Man get down on the track?
Not at this time.
Or just wait for your word.
Steve Dorr is just down there getting congratulations from anybody coming his way right now. as we'll go down trackside now with Jim Mojette and your winner, Steve Doerr. Take it away, Jim.
Steve Doerr, you just won the Seal Wrap Redbud 300.
Unbelievable. What a race, man. I've heard about this race and seen this race and heard about the little 500. I want to do so many things. I want to thank God for being here and for helping me. I want to thank the minister that comes here and prays with us. I want to thank all you guys. I want to thank the people at home listening on the internet, my sister Christy, my mom, Dick and Shirley, and Raymond, and all the guys at Race Car Engineering, man. That's a parts store. It sells parts all over the United States. What a great sponsor. Finish Line Race Cars, All-Star Performance Products, Performance Brakes, Bassett Wheels, Daniel, my crew chief from Finish Line. What a great job. The guy and me just get along great. And my dad, my girlfriend Katie, Randy, and every person that's here tonight, thank everybody that made this possible. Thank all you guys. Unbelievable. To pass Chase Elliott, he's got such a good team. Thanks, man. And to do it on the outside was, I'd never thought. I knew I had a good car, but
you started wow. 17.
I know. Unbelievable, man. I just want to cry, people. This is unreal to win this race and have my family here. Wow. Finish Line Race Cars. Daniel, everybody, thank you guys. Thank everybody.
Coming back next year?
I believe so.
Yeah, I believe so.
I'll try.
Thank you very much. Steve Doerr, let's hear it for him.